Bonjour tout le monde. Aujourd'hui, c'est jeudi le 13 janvier. The only things you have to do today are practice with le mot de passe and use that to complete your Flipgrid from yesterday if you've not yet done so. Une discussion, continue slash finish up your quick writes and your quick write reflection, étudier pour l'examen. And actually, if you happen to watch this video, I will tell you here that the final is actually already live on Schoology. So if you want, you can go ahead and take that now. It will also be available all day tomorrow. It is using a lockdown browser, so you won't be able to access other tabs during the exam. I am experimenting with this for the first time, so hopefully that will work out well. But yes, if you happen to see this video, then your little bonus is that you know that the exam is available. So then also, if you want any extra help, you can always listen again to La Chanson. I really kind of dropped the ball on doing any kind of a activity with it this week. I'll try again next week or the week after. Et TPR, you can always be practicing that. It's going to come in handy for the exam. Aujourd'hui dans l'histoire, c'est jeudi le 13 janvier, c'est l'anniversaire de Françoise David, une femme militante et féministe québécoise. Québécoise is referring to being from the province of Quebec. So she is not French, she's actually Canadian. Elle est née en 1948 à Montréal. Montréal, as we know it, probably Montreal, is not actually the capital of Quebec. But it is the biggest city in Quebec. In fact, it's the second biggest city population-wise, second biggest French city. Let's try that again. Second biggest French-speaking city in the world after Paris. Elle a fondé beaucoup de mouvements qui luttent contre la pauvreté et la violence contre les femmes. Fondé, so she founded beaucoup de mouvements. So movements in terms of just mobilizing people, fundraising, etc., qui lutte, that fight against, contre, la pauvreté, poverty, et la violence contre les femmes, so violence against women specifically. Elle a pris sa retraite. En 2017, elle a pris sa retraite. She retired, so she's no longer working in that sphere officially. Okay, les deux questions. Where was she born? What causes did she fight for? I just kind of went over that, so hopefully you'll be able to answer that pretty easily, en français ou en anglais. And that is it for today. So if you have any questions, always let me know. Otherwise, au revoir tout le monde.